see us too.
She's like 35 or something.
Oh.
Got it.
Everything worked out?
Awesome. I don't think so. I gave both the kids water, by the way, just a heads up on that.
She is yeah. somewhere.
Thank you.
I think she's
nice to see you.
Going to the bathroom.
Good morning. Shabbat Shalom. Mazel Tov.
Well, they
hi,
have
Mazel Tov.
It's like
so nice to have you here.
And then, like, for the rabbi, and it goes,
yeah,
there's a cupbearer, so if you need
great.
To turn
are all the
up.
Grandparents here?
Yeah, there's cool signs.
Awesome.
Really yeah. They have signs.
Okay. Yeah.
Well,
no problem.
Like, mic up.
Yeah.
When they come back up, I want to just welcome you guys again and also give you a little few stage directions we have here. So thanks for your flexibility.
I think you're speaking from this mic right here. Yeah.
You want to come up and test it? You're welcome to. It's nice and loud. Oh, it is.
Paris, are you really the first bar mitzvah here? First double bar.
First double.
God.
Good morning. Mazel Tov. Shabbat Shalom.
No. Is it in the program? I didn't look in. Oh, not. Yeah, no, is that it? Good Lord.
Awesome. So I think some of the other grandmas are in the ladies' room. So when they come, great. Okay. So when everybody's here, we'll have a little discussion. Nice to meet you, Mazel Tov. Welcome.
Should I talk through my mask?
If possible, yes.
Yeah. So that's.
Sorry.
Well, that's gotta be Ezekiel.
If possible,
Ezekiel
that would be great.
Like that.
If it's,
but I don't know.
If it's too hard, then don't. You can do that. Can you?
Yeah.
You can test the mic though. It's definitely on.
No, just the Haftorah?
Just got to stand a little close to it, I think.
What term is
it
on?
They didn't
can you,
trust something like that
Abby?
To the kids, huh?
Can you guys hear this mic?
Can't Rogan.
Is this mic on?
Yeah,
it is.
Okay.
It's just a little loud in here.
Is this a good voice tone?
I think so. I think that's good.
Okay. Today we're celebrating the 11th victory of the Los Angeles Dodgers.
Great. Hello, all right. Shabbat Shalom.
Yeah.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, awesome. Okay.
May you have auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous. Sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. May the best...
I don't know. okay, so... Are you Melvin or Franklin? Melvin. Great. Okay. Nice to meet you, Melvin. Trying to put my names to faces here. So great. Awesome. I know Harris, so that helps me. All right. Great. Awesome. Nice to meet you again. Mazel Tov. Mazel Tov.
Hey, Corey.
Yeah. So Harris and Carolyn
no,
and Sandra and Franklin.
Yeah.
Good morning. Shabbat Shalom. So I just, for the Talit presentation and for the Aliyah that we have, so we have a few spots for you. So Harris, you'll come up with Carolyn to the mic for the Talit presentation because you're speaking. And then I'd love for two of you to be over here at that little X and two of you over here at that little X. And Justin and Jillian will, so there's a little on the ground.
Right,
sorry about that. So Jillian will be on this side, and Justin will be on this side. They're going to come down, and you're going to give them their talit when the rabbi tells you to do that. And the rabbi will guide them in the blessing for the talit, okay? So it's just logistical, so you guys are spaced out a little bit. So we'll have Justin over here with two of you, and Jillian over here, and Harris and Carolyn. Carolyn, is that right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Up here. Does that sound good? That's okay. Of course, yes. So for the Talit presentation, which is toward the beginning of the service, so Harris is going to come up with Joyce. Is that right? Sorry. Carolyn, I'm sorry. I knew I was going to mess up the names. So Harris and Carolyn will come on up. If you need a railing, there's one over there. You're welcome to also use, you know, this if you want to, but there's railings on both sides if you need. So Harris and Carolyn will come on up, and then... So two of you will stay right down here. Yeah. Great. Yes, of course. So two of you will... So who would like to be on this side with Justin? Does it make a difference? Okay. Great. Okay, so you'll be Jillian. Exactly. So, and you'll have the tally tote with you, so
Justin,
you can put them on.
Justin's going to be on one side, Jillian's on the other.
Correct. Yes.
Jojo, your hair.
Yeah. Does that make sense?
Your hair.
Yeah, so that way everyone can have their own space.
We go under
your head. No, I apologize.
There you go.
All good. And we're gonna try to do the same thing for the Aliyah, which is when you're called up to the Torah. So we're gonna recite all your Hebrew names. And then what we'd like to do is have two of you down here and one of you up here. Everyone can do it all together. You'll just be spread out. Great, wonderful. So you guys can decide who, if you want to rotate, you can. If both of you want to be on the Bima, one of you can do the opening blessing, and then you can swap.
Yeah, strange, very strange.
Great.
All good.
Great, so you two will go up for the Torah blessing, and you guys will just stay down here below. Fabulous,
yeah.
Thank you so much. Correct, so only two of you up here at a time. Yeah, so thank you for understanding. correct, yes.
All right.
Due to the kind of restrictions with hybrid that we have here, we had to shorten the service, so unfortunately we only have four Aliyahs.
We were in Wintergreen this past week before.
Go to like that.
And we had some of your wine in celebration, yeah. Yeah, I can't remember where
course,
we had it.
Of course, of course. And
we,
don't worry, like,
we
take your
to,
time in moving up and down.
Still...
If you want, you're welcome to walk behind me as I'm chanting, or go this way if you'd like the railing.
Yes, yeah,
I'm
going to
be chanting during the Aliyah
that
you guys are doing the blessings for.
Yeah.
So
yes.
It will not distract me. Don't. Jillian and Justin will be sitting there looking wonderful.
TV.
So don't worry about moving and bothering anybody, okay? Yeah. For the beginning of the service, I think you're going to start down here, and then we'll make sure you come on up for the Talit presentation.
It was an option presented to us.
All right.
When you're up here,
right.
Let me get an answer for you on that question. Harris asked me the same question.
As you probably remember, it's
okay. No problem. If you're comfortable wearing your mask, that'd be ideal. But if you feel moved. We're not going to come up to you and go,
listen,
yeah,
I hear you.
Yeah, of course, preferably wearing the mask.
During a pandemic,
yes.
Too.
Yeah. Thank you so much. I know this is a different experience for us all. Yeah, great. Well, we're happy you're here, too. This is awesome.
Is everyone straight?
Yeah, is everyone, yes. So, right to here. Yes. Yeah. So I'll be chanting. I'll be chanting Torah. If you want to see where I start, you're welcome to come over. Just don't say anything. yeah. You can if you want to, or you can just do the Aliyah. Yeah. Whatever is most comfortable. Yeah. I'm not. Yes. Yes, if you have the Talit tote, that would be great. we're all clear? Thank you so much.
Yes.
All right, awesome.
Yeah. Okay, this is Martin.
Hi.
Really
good?
Looks like what I pick out.
Okay. they're going to start in the pews, right? They're not going to be up here at the beginning of the service. the Tully presentation.
Correct. They wanted it to be
So we'll just, it's toward the beginning of the service. It's in the outline that I gave you. So it's like, I think so. They just have to be ready to come on up, so. Yeah, that's a great, great idea.
What?
Okay, we good?
Justin's is different.
Yep.
I decided to wear these ones, these glasses. For now, reasons that feel really ridiculous because like my other glasses have like nose like pieces.
Yeah.
And so like if I like put them further down to like not get them fogged up, they don't like slide off, but these like slide off.
Yeah, my DeVartoro. Oh, that's loud.
I know.
That's what I wear. Yeah.
I have to get it in order.
Yeah. Yeah, it's toward the very beginning of the service. Yep, toward the very beginning. Oh, yeah, the rabbi's in charge of the direction here. For he will guide you in the best way. So.
Well, that's the best I can. It will be toward the beginning of the service, not the very, very beginning.
So yeah.
Probably about like 5 minutes after we start.
The first one. Yeah.
No, they can sit where they would normally, where they're going to be sitting for the service. They can. I'll call them by name.
Great. The nerves are starting to go. Yep. Great.
Oh, that's the wire.
Awesome. Yeah. And I'm going to be the one chanting that Aliyah, so just so you know. So Justin and Jillian will be sitting right there. They're going to read a little bit later. Yep, they're going to read a little bit later. Yep, yeah. So they're going to do pieces of the service. So they're going to do, so they're going to do a little bit in Shacharit, and then they're going to do all of the Torah service. They'll be leading the Torah service. Jillian's going to be chanting Torah. Justin will be chanting Haftorah. And then they're going to close out the Torah service, and then Justin's going to help lead Musaf. So good chunks of it, yes. Not all of it. It depends on the student. Justin had a lot more time learning with me because he was supposed to be last year, so but yes, yeah, of course. No, I would leave that down there if you can. That's not from us. No. So yeah, right, yeah, right, of course, yeah. Well, Mazel Tov again. Yeah, of course. Okay. We're good? You're wearing two masks. Tell me how that goes. At the end, not right now. You have to tell me at the end how it feels.
I don't think it's the two mask thing, but I'm just.
The glasses.
Yeah, it's really annoying.
Okay.
Justin, is that on right?
Makes me feel a little less insane that Corey is too.
Oh, he is. So is Lexi.
A lot of people here.
Oh yeah, I'm not. I don't disagree with you. You are not wrong. Not wrong at all. So.
Justin, your microphone looks a little askew. Oh, I see.
When I'm talking, it doesn't.
Like when you're talking just to people.
Yeah. Or,
you'll put it back. Okay, all right.
How you guys feeling?
Good.
Good? Awesome. Awesome, awesome. It's going to be great.
Just the book.
Okay.
Where's our book?
We'll get started in just a few minutes if we can.
Oh, no,
there's Opal!
It's in the back. Okay. Probably.
You guys have a prayer book?
I don't.
Make sure you have one, okay? Do you need one? Sorry?
Yeah, I need one.
You need one?
Okay. Actually, I don't know. Yeah, I need one.
Okay.
Did you leave it in the car?
Here we go. I knew that was going to happen. Well. So you're going to want to hold on to that, Jillian, because I want you to follow along during the service, okay?
All right.
You're sitting there.
I know. Okay.
I think we're ready for showtime up here, so feel free to count us in when it's time.
Oh, I didn't know that. I'm sorry.
Wait, what is it?
They can unwrap it now if they want.
Ooh, it's pretty.
Ah, beautiful. Lovely. Awesome. You guys can leave those up here if you want. Thank you so much. I didn't realize. Awesome. Beautiful. That's so lovely. How nice. All right, I'm going to leave those there for you, okay? All right, thank you. Sorry about that.
Did I bring my water up here? I did not. Can you get my water?
Is my mic still on? You can hear me, right? Okay, good.
Live streaming?
So I said to Jillian to follow along while they were going through the service. The rabbi's going to announce some pages, okay? So that way you'll know when the Shema is coming, all right? That's the first thing you guys, after the Talit presentation, you guys will, we'll come on up. So you can leave those on your seat when you go down for the Talit presentation, okay?
Never mind. All right. Streaming to both our account and their account. Yeah.
Make sure to do the blessing for the Talit with them.
Excuse me?
The Talit blessing, they need back and forth.
I'm not sure if I understood your...
The Talit bracha,
yeah.
They just need back and forth. Like
they need to be prompted.
Correct. Yeah. You guys will do some repeat after the rabbi for the Talit, okay? Okay.
Something. You want me to say more? Is that okay? Testing 1 2 1 2.
Shivitenu kafikim banegev azorim bedima derina itzoru shir hamalot veshuv Adonai et Shivat Zion Hayinu Kechovim Az Yimavet Tzchokinu Ulshoneinu Rina Shir Hamalot Shuva Adonai et Shivat Zion Hayinu Kecholim Az Yimaleh Tzchokinu Ulshoneinu Rina Yainai
the fortunes of Zion. It will be as a dream. Our mouths will be filled with laughter, our tongues with song. The nations will say how the Infinite has raised them up. The Infinite will raise us up and we will be happy. Make our return, Infinite God, like the streams suddenly gushing in the Negev. May those who sow with tears harvest with song. In tears, the sower walks back and forth carrying the basket of seed. May the farmer return. carrying the harvested sheaves, singing. Shabbat Shalom, and welcome everybody. A few weeks ago, as we began a process of returning to the sanctuary, hopefully a process that will continue and expand in the weeks and months to come, we decided to begin with the words of this psalm, Psalm 126, set to the beautiful melody of Joe Weisenberg, reminding us of the challenges of the past year and the extraordinary joy of now fulfilling the promise of returning to this sacred space. And we do so this Shabbat, celebrating our first bar and bat mitzvah in person in the sanctuary in over a year. It is a special joy to be with the Fracking family, guests, and all of you as we celebrate Shabbat and celebrate Justin and Jillian. We'll begin our service on page 147 with Shochein Ad.
Shochein ad marom v'kadosh shemo. Shochein ad marom v'kadosh shemo. Lecha tzarenet uvyoshon chasidim tidromam, uvekerev kedoshim tidkadash, uvmagalot rivevot, amechabit Yisrael. Shekein chovat choytrim lefanecha Adonai Eloheinu ve'Elohei Avoteinu, leodol hallel l'shabeach lefayem lerumem lehader, levarech maleu kol ha'yisrael kol divrei shirot v'tishbechot, David ben Yishai, avdecha meshichecha.
We'll pause now for a moment and invite onto the Bima, near the Bima, Justin and Jillian, along with their grandparents, Melvin and Joyce Fradkin, Sandra and Franklin Levin, and Carolyn and Harris Raskine, to present them with their talitot and to place them on their shoulders for the first time.
J&J, Justin, you are the tallest bar mitzvah boy I have ever seen. In fact, Jillian, as a horse maven, would you say that he is about 17 hands high? That and other factors make your mitzvahs incredibly unique. Justin and Jillian, you are the most recent B'nai mitzvah in Richmond, and Jeffrey Brown and I were the very first ever at Bethel quite a few years ago. It's also unique that my cousin Jeff is a descendant of the large Brown family, as your father is, and I am a descendant of the large Siegel family, as your mother is. You have more grandparents present than I have ever seen at any bar or bas mitzvah. We welcome Melvin and Joyce, Franklin and Sandra, Carolyn and me, Shehehiyanu. It's also unique that for all these years, we have often called the two of you J and J. Little did we know after the year 2020, we would be finally able to get together and to celebrate because of another J and J. So to both of you, wear this tallis proudly as young Jewish adults. Mazel tov and love. Saba and Jojo, Zeze and Bubby, Carolyn and Papa.
Oh, amen. Thank you for those beautiful words, Harris. And I'm going to lead Justin and Jillian in the blessing. We're putting on the tallit. Baruch atah Adonai. Eloheinu melech ha'olam,
Eloheinu melech ha'olam,
asher kitshanu,
Asher Kedeshan.
Mitzvotav Vetzivanu.
Mitzvotav Vetzivanu.
Lehit Atev.
Lehit Atev.
Batzitzit.
Batzitzit.
Amen. And as you reach this moment where you take on the responsibility for fulfilling the commandments, so too may you merit to live a life of Torah, to attain chupa, meaningful and loving relationships in your life, and ma'asim tovim, deeds of goodness and righteousness. Amen. Now give grandparents a kiss and a hug. And we'll continue on page 148 with Yishtabach. It's customary to rise.
Yishtabach Shimcha Lad Malkeinu.
Yishtabach Shimcha Lad Malkeinu.
Amen.
Amen. Baruch Adonai Yavorach Le'olam Va'ed.
Baruch Adonai Yavorach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam Yotzer Or Uvorech Hashach Oseh Shalom Uvareh Et HaKol.
You may be seated. We continue on page 151.
El Adon HaKol HaMasim Baruch Umborach Bevivo Neshama Gadlo Metzivo Male Olam Tatu Tvuna So Bevimoto HaMikael Chayot HaKodesh Benedar Bechavor Alam Merkava Zechut Umishor Bivne Chiso Chetze Berachamim Bivne Kevodo Tovim Be'orot Shebara Eloheinu Yitzaram Bedar
Yeshua Deha.
158, we'll continue on together with the Amidah, which begins on page 159.
Zor Yisrael, Kuma B'ezrat Yisrael, Uftekin Umecha, Yudah B'Yisrael, Goalinu Adonai Tzevaot Shemo, Kedosh Yisrael, Baruch Adonai, Gal Yisrael, Adonai Tzevatai Tiftach, Ufiyagit Yilatacha, Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu ve'Elohe avoteinu, Elohe Abraham, Elohe Yitzchak, Elohe Yaakov, Elohe Sarah, Elohe Rivka, Elohe Rachel, Elohe Leah, Ha'el HaGadol HaGibor V'Hanora, Elohion, Gomel Chasadim Tovim, Ve'Koneh Hakol, Ve'Zocher Chasdei Avot, U'Mevi Goel Ibnei B'neihem, Leman Shemo Be'Ava, Melech Ozeruch Okeinu Moshiach Umagin, Baruch Atah Adonai, Magin Abraham Ufoked Sarah, Atah Gibor L'Kolam Adonai, Nechaye Metim Atarab Le'Moshiach, Morid Atal, Mechakel Chayim Bechesed, Nechaye Metim Berachamim Rabin, So that no flim verofe holim, umatir asurim, umekayem emunato, lishende afar, micha mocha bagiburot, umido melach, melach menit umekayem, umatmiach yeshua, venem akalach ayod metim,
baruch
Adonai Mechayeti.
Baruch kevod Adonai mimkomo.
Baruch kevod Adonai mimkomo. Mimkom chamalkenu tofia v'timloch aleinu kimechakim anachnu lach. Matai timloch v'tzion bekarov v'yamenu. Le'olam v'etishkon tikadal v'tikadash. V'toch Yerushalayim yircha l'dor v'dor ol netzach netzachim. V'einenu tirena tirena malchutecha. Kad avar ha'amor v'shireu zecha. V'einenu tirena Tirena malchutecha, kadavar ha'amur, v'shirei uzecha. Ayedei David, Mashiach tizkecha.
Yimloch anay lelam elohayich tzion, nedor vador, hallelujah.
Yimloch anay lelam elohayich tzion, nedor vador, hallelujah. Ledor vador nagig odlecha, unetzach mitzachim kidushatecha anaktish. V'shichacha Eloheinu mipinen lo yamush lelamayed. Kiel melech gadol v'kadosh ata.
Oseh shalom bimromav, u'yaseh shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'imru, amen. Yigadal v'gadash mei rabah, ve'amadi brak yirutei v'amlich malchutei, v'chayachonu v'yomachonu chay d'chol beit Yisrael, v'agalav izman karmi v'imaru, amen. Yesh mei rabah nevorah,
May be seated as we turn to the Psalm for Shabbat, page 112.
Hi, Yom Yom Shabbat Kodesh, Shabbat Yavim Omrim Bebet HaMikdash. He's more surely Yom HaShabbat, Tov Leodol Adonai, Vulzamer L'Shimcha El Yor. Lagi Baruch Hazes Vavadal
Yisrael. Kis Anachna, Magalim Asach Alei Ben Roshotecha. Yipar Diyukob Leyo Bebet HaMikdash. Odi Nebum Besev HaDashim.
Sadi Katamar Yifra Kertwan Yisgash, and Yedal Yisrael. Od yet you can be say that the shame running you. The Agitia shard and I, to read the love left above.
We invite those in mourning and those observing your sights and all who wish to say Kaddish to rise as you are able. In the Mourner's Kaddish, page 121. Yitgadal v'yitkadash shemei rabah.
Amen.
Ve'alma divra kirute v'yamlich mochute. V'chayechon v'yomechon v'chaye d'chol beit Yisrael. V'agala v'izman kari v'imru. Amen. Yehe shmei rabah neborach ve'alam alme almaya. Yibarach v'yishtabach v'yipa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnase. V'yitadar v'yitale v'yitalal shemei d'kudusha b'richu. Leila min kol birchata v'shirata tishbechata v'nechemata damiran be'alma v'imru amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shemaya v'chaim aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. Oseh shalom b'romav hu ya'aseh shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen.
Amen.
May the one who makes peace on high make peace for us, for all Israel, for all who dwell on earth. Let us say amen.
Amen.
Be seated. We'll turn now to the Torah service, which begins on page 168. Justin and Jillian are going to lead us. Page
168. Adonai Malach, Adonai Imlach, Le'olam Va'ed, Adonai Os Le'amo Itain, Adonai Yivorech, Et Amo V'Shalom, Av HaRachamim, Hetiv Avir Samcha, Et Zion, Tivnei Chomot, Yerushalayim, Tivnei Chomot, Yerushalayim.
It's customary to rise as the ark is open. Servants of the Holy One, who we revere and whose precious Torah we revere in every time and place. Not on mortals do we rely, nor upon angels do we depend, but rather upon the God of the universe, the God of truth, whose Torah is truth, whose prophets are truth, and who abounds in deeds of goodness and truth.
Kaisha yakira, ana emar tushbechan, ve'ana rafetz, ve'ana rafetz, ve'lish me'kaisha, kaisha yakira, ana emar tushbechan, yehera avakodamach,
Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad.
Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad.
Echad Eloheinu, Gadol Adoneinu, Kadosh Shemo.
Echad Eloheinu, Shamayim uvaaretz, kivoh vashamayim uvaaretz. Echadonai, amamacha ve'aminase, ve'chol erosh,
romemu, romemu.
Adonai Eloheinu, ve'ishtachavu, ve'ishtachavu. Ve'adom raglav kadoshu,
romenu,
romenu, Adonai Eloheinu, ve'ishachavu, ve'ishachavu, ve'har kodesho. Yigadosh Adonai Eloheinu. May be seated. Well, this Shabbat, somewhat appropriately, I believe, we are reading Parashat Tazria Metzora, the portion from the book of Leviticus known as Tazria Metzora, which you can find if you have a Bible, a Chumash, Leviticus chapter 14, verse 6, which is found on page 661 of the Eitz Chaim Chumash, 470 in the Hertz. Why I say that it is an appropriate Parsha is because Tazria Metzora primarily deals with a plague, with an illness, and in particular, how the priest helps to enable those who are afflicted with the illness to re-enter and reintegrate back into the community and back into society. Worthy for us to consider and learn this Shabbat. Justin and Jillian will share with us a little bit more about the Torah portion in a little while, but worthy for us to think about and consider this Shabbat as we, for the first time, are reintegrating back into in-person community with this first bar in Bat Mitzvah since before the pandemic. Once again, the portion can be found Leviticus chapter 14, verse 6, Eitz Chaim, page 661, Hertz, page 470.
Ve'azor ve'agen ve'yoshia l'chol chakosim bo ben amar. Amen. Hakol avugot el Eloheinu nuchavod la'Torah. Yamdu Ya'el ben Tzvi ve'Mordechai ben Yaakov. Ve'Tzvi ben Baruch. Ve'Tzipora bat Yosef Ephraim. Vermleib ben Yitzhak Rachmiel. Halia Rishona. Baruch
Shana Tantra Lemus
Israel,
Big Tusha Tel. Was it my Viking Banarechem, Chaim Kochem,
Hayo?
When we are welcoming Justin and Jillian's grandparents for the first Aliyah, you'll note that there are aspects of our Torah service and our Torah reading that are slightly askew from tradition. This Shabbat, this has been the case, of course, over the past year. As we've navigated the particularities of Jewish ritual that is designed for in-person gathering for when we have not been in person virtually and now in our hybrid services. So we are, of course, doing things a little bit differently, but nevertheless, we hope beautifully and meaningfully. Once again, the portion can be found page 661 in the Eitz Chaim, 470 in the Hertz.
Baruch Hu Adonai HaMarach,
Baruch Adonai HaMarach Le'olam Vaed,
Baruch Adonai HaMarach Le'olam Vaed, Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam, Asher Bach Avanu Mikol Avanim, V'Natan Manu Et
Yachayai Kachuta, Vedeta Erez, et Shnei Hatulat, Ved Haizov, Vetavalotam, Vedeta Tiporachaya, Vedama Tiporashuta, Alhamayim Achayim, Vehiza, Al Hamitaher, Min Hatzarat, Sheva Pamim, Vetiharo, Vishilach, Etatiporachaya, Alpine Hasade, Vehibe, Samitaher, Begadav, Vigalach, Ekosaro, Verachat, Bamaim, Vetaher, Veachar Yabo, El Hamachane, Vayasha, Mikuzolo, Shivat Yamim, Vehaya, Vayomashmi, Vayomashvi, Yigaleach, Et Kosaro, Et Rosho, Et Zekano, Et Gabot, Enav, Et Kosaro, Yigaleach, Vichy Bez, Et Bigada, Verachat, Et Besaro, Bamaim, Vetaher, Uvayomashmidi, Yikach, Shne Kivasim, Timimim, Uch Basa, Achat, Bachinatat, Timima, Ushosha, Esronim, So let me have a lava shemen, Vilogechat, Shaman. Ve'ha'emid ha'kohen ha'mitaher, et ha'et ha'ish ha'mitaher, ve'otam lifnei Adonai petach ohel mo'ed. Ve'lakach ha'kohen et ha'keves ha'chad, ve'hikriv oto le'asham, ve'dlok ha'shamen ve'heniv otam, tenufa lifnei Adonai.
Now to offer our prayers for those in our lives and those in our community who are in need of healing. If you have someone for whom you are praying this Shabbat, I invite you to rise as I recite the traditional words of the prayer for healing and then pause to include the names in our congregational list. And that's a good opportunity for you to hold in your thoughts anybody for whom you might be praying this Shabbat, and whether or not you have anybody in particular in mind, I invite you to join in with Cantor Rosenblatt as she leads us in the English words of the prayer. Misha berach avotinu Avraham Yitzhak Yaakov imotinu sariv karach avaleha hu yivarech nir petach olim bekilateinu.
Misha berach avotinu mekor habracha limotinu. May the source of strength who bless the ones before us help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing, and let us say, Amen. Mishabeirach imoteinu, mekor habracha le'avoteinu. Bless those in need of healing with refuah shleima, the renewal of body, the renewal of spirit, and let us say, Amen.
We pray that all those in need of healing experience a full and complete recovery of both body and spirit. And though Shabbat is a time in which we normally refrain from petition, we nevertheless hope and pray that healing at hand, aided by the spiritual strength that Shabbat affords. And let us say, Amen.
Amen.
May the one who blessed our ancestors bless all those who put themselves at risk to care for the sick, physicians and nurses and orderlies, technicians and home health aides, EMTs and pharmacists, and social workers who navigate the unfolding dangers of the world each day to tend to those they have sworn to help. Bless also all those who labor in the midst of this pandemic, shelter those who grow our food in the field, guide in peace those who deliver basic needs by road, track, and air, uplift those bent low, bearing loads in manufacturing and sanitation. Send love to those who connect us through wire, wave, and cable. Provide companionship to those who work in solitude, ease to those who work in anguish, safety to those who step into harm's way, dignity to all whose labor benefits us. Bless them in their coming home and bless them in their going out. Ease their fear and sustain them. Source of all breath, healer of all beings, protect them and restore their hope. Strengthen them that they may bring strength. Keep them in health that they may bring healing. Help them know again a time when we can breathe without fear. Bless the sacred work of their hands. May this plague pass from among us speedily and in our days, and let us say, Amen.
Yam du Esther Batsvi Vitzipora Vit David Leib Ben Mordechai Ve'Yael Aliashnia.
Welcome Justin and Jillian's parents, David and Esther, for the second Aliyah.
Baruch Hu Adonai Hamara.
Baruch Adonai Hamarach Le'olam Va'ed.
Baruch Adonai Hamarach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Ha'amin V'natan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Atah Adonai Notein HaTorah.
Amen.
V'shachat Et HaKeves B'mkom Asher Yishkat Et HaChatat Et Allah b'mkom HaKodesh ki kachata tasham hu la kohen kodesh karashim hu vela kacha kohen midam hasham v'natan hakohen al tinuch ozen hamitaher haymanit velbo en yado haymanit velbo en raglo haymanit vela kacha kohen milo kasham en vayitzak al kacha kohen asimalit v'tabala kohen V'tabal ha-kohen et etzba'o emanit min ha-shemen asher al-kafo ha-simalit v'yiza min ha-shemen betzba'o sheva pamim lifnei Adonai u'mi-yeter ha-shemen asher al-kafo yitain ha-kohen al-tenuch ozen ha-mitaher emanit v'albo en yado ha-imanit v'albo en raglo emanit al-dam ha-sham v'hanotar b'shemen asher al-kaf ha-kohen yitain ha-rosh ha-mitaher v'kiper alav HaKohen lifnei Adonai V'asa HaKohen et hachatat V'chiper al hamitaher Mitumato V'achar yishchat Yishchat et ha'olah V'he'elah HaKohen et ha'olah V'et hamincha V'hamizbecha V'chiper alav HaKohen betaher V'imdalhu V'en yado Maseget V'lakach keves echad Asham lit nufat lechaper alav veisar alav veisaron solet echad balul v'ashem en lemincha velok shamen ushtei torim o shnei bnei yona asher tasig yado veyachad chatat veachad ola vehevi otam v'yom hashmini letarato el hakohen el petach o'el mo'ed lifnei Adonai.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam asher natan lanu Torah emet v'chaye olam nata b'dorkeinu. Baruch atah Adonai notein ha'Torah.
Amen. It's now my pleasure and joy to invite David and Esther to share some words of blessing with Justin and Jillian on this special day.
Justin and Jillian, this exact moment in time is one of the most special moments in a parent's life, and we are cherishing every moment, although we are a bit nervous. It is even more special because we have the honor of blessing you together and to celebrate you both becoming an adult in the eyes of Jewish law. We are equally thankful to be able to share this moment, the four of us together, along with our incredibly supportive family and dearest friends. This is truly a mitzvah and a blessing. As Papa mentioned, 68 years ago, he and his cousin had the first B'nai Mitzvah at Temple Bethel. And today, we have the honor of celebrating your B'nai Mitzvah. In addition to Papa, your other grandparents, who are here today in the sanctuary, stood on this very bima and read from this Torah, just as you will today. Your uncles, cousins, and your mom and dad stood in this very spot as we became a bar and bat mitzvah. And your mom and I were married here 16 years ago. This is truly a special place for our family. Now a bit about the two of you. Justin, since the day you were born, you were and continue to be incredibly sweet, caring, empathetic towards others, and always with a smile, at least when you're awake. You're a gifted sleeper, just like your father. We had to wake you to eat, and then you would go right back to sleep. And this went on for about the first 5 years of your life. You also love to help people. Here's one example. Several years back, we received a call from a parent thanking us for sticking up for their son. You recognized your friends not being included in a school pickup game. You gathered your friends and arranged for everyone to stand back on the field so that your friend could finally have a chance to catch a pass. You made his day and certainly made us proud of you. Another example of the numerous comments we received from your school and teachers. One story that stands out is the time a teacher pulled you out of class so you could fix another teacher's electronic whiteboard. You are only 10 years old. You are always willing to help others, and you are a natural problem solver. You have a quick laugh, a great sense of humor, and the best dimples in the world. You see the positive, stray away from the negative, and as much as we try to get you to tell us a little scoop at home, you just won't do it. The only person in the world that is exempt from this is your sister. Keep working hard, pursue your passion, and stay true to yourself. We love watching you mature. Great things are on the horizon, and we can't wait to see what you accomplish next. In case you couldn't tell, we love you.
Jillian, it's a girl. We will never forget when we heard those words. We knew at that very moment that our family was complete. Like your brother, you were such a sweet and happy baby, not such a good sleeper. You were also a very determined child. On your second birthday, I was helping you put on a dress for your party, and you stopped me and said, "No." I had never heard you say this before. You had your own idea about what you would wear to that party. You developed from a very early age a determination, style, and conviction that you continue to carry with you today. You have always known exactly what you want. You are blessed with a fiery spirit. We admire your ability to envision your goals, your sense of humor, and your creativity. And you go for it every time. When working on a project, you have an immediate sense for your finished product, and you know how to roll up your sleeves, tackle the job, and it works like a charm every time. In a few minutes, we will hear you chant from the Torah. Its meaning, which you will speak about in your Devar Torah, was very challenging to say the least. Your persistence and drive allowed you to fight through the challenge and find meaning and purpose and how it relates to our world today. We have always known how special you are, but when we hear it from others, it has even greater meaning. Your teachers love to share stories with us that exemplify your spirit, and one in particular described you as having true grit. You have also been described as having a strong sense of humor, a strong sense of what is right and wrong, and a great sense of humor. Shifting gears. You're so lucky to have found your passion early in your life. Watching you horseback ride, whether you're taking a lesson, practicing in the ring, competing, summarizes all the great things about you. Your ability to work as one with a 1,000-pound animal is impressive to watch, and at times seems so easy for you. You have never shied away from a challenge, and the more of a challenge, the more determined, focused, and grittier you get. We never know what to expect. You want to try everything: soccer, lacrosse, field hockey, piano, ukulele, drawing. You want to experience all that life has to offer. This is an incredible quality, and as with your brother, we are so excited to see where life takes you. You both have so much to look forward to, and we are blessed to be able to come along for the ride. We love you.
Amen. And to those words of blessing, we'll add the traditional words of blessing for special occasions such as these. Shachianu, I want to invite grandparents to rise as you're able. I don't know exactly who's here, but if there are other family members, aunts, uncles, you're welcome to, cousins, open to rise. Stay up here for just a moment. I want to, Justin, why don't you remain standing for just a moment. We're going to say Shehecheyanu together for this special occasion. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Shehecheyanu V'Kiyamanu V'Higiyanu Lazman Hazeh. Blessed are you, infinite God, sovereign of space and time, who has kept us alive and sustained us and brought us to this special moment.
Tamud, Habakura bat Hamitzvah, Yafa Brucha bat David ve'Esther, Haliyah Shlishit Chazak Chazak.
Baruch Hu Adonai Hamvara.
Baruch Adonai.
Asher b'har b'ani mikol chamim, v'natan lani v'torato, baruch ata nai, noten ha-torah.
Amen.
V'lakach ha-kohen, et kebes ha-asham, v'et log ha-shamen, v'hinif otam ha-kohen, tenufa livnei Adonai, v'shahat et keves ha-asham v'lakach ha-kohen midam ha-asham v'natan al tenu ozen ha-mitaher ha-manit ve'al bohen yado ha-manit ve'al bohen yad raglo ha-manit umi ha-shemen yitzo ha-kohen Akaf HaKohen HaSemalit Behizach HaKohen Betzbao Haimanit Min HaShemen Asher Alkapo HaSemalit Sheva Pe'amim Lifnei Adonai Benotar HaKohen Min HaShemen Asher Al kapo,
al tenu,
ozen hamitaher, haimanit, ve'al bohen, yado, haimanit, ve'al bohen, raglo, haimanit, al mikom, dam, ha'asham, ve'chanotar, min ha'shemen, v'asher, al kah ha'kohen, yitain al rosh, hamitaher, Lechaper, Olav, Livnei Adonai. Ve'atza et ha'echad min ha'torim, O min b'nei ha'yuna, Me'asher tasig yado, Et asher tasig yado. Et ha'echad ha'tat, Ve'et ha'echad Olav, Rechaper ha-kohen, O ha-mitaher, livnei Adonai, Zotorat, asher bo, nega zarat, asher, lo tasig yado, betahorato. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam, asher natan lanu Torah emet, v'hayei olam natan b'doheinu, baruch ata Adonai noten ha-Torah.
Amen. Mi sheberach avotenu Avraham Yitzchak v'Yaakov.
Julian, stay up
here. Mi sheberach avotenu Avraham Yitzchak v'Yaakov, v'yivarech Rivka Rachel v'Leah, hu yivarech. Et yafa brucha bat David ve'ester shehigia le'mitzvot al'tayom lichvod ha'makom v'lichvod ha'torah v'lichvod ha'shabbat HaKadosh Baruch Hu yishmerecha v'chayeha yichonen et liba liyot shalem im Adonai Eloheha l'hagot b'torato l'lechet b'drachav v'lichmor mitzvota v'yot amata v'imso et yuda v'liyot isha ohebet v'ahuba u'bne hayom u'kol yom l'cheinu chesed rachamim בינך ובינך רואה, ושלח ברכה, והצלחה בכל מעשי ידיה, היא רצון שיזכו הוריה, לגדלה לתורה, לחופה ומעשים טובים, ונאמר אמן.
May the one who blessed our ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah, bless Jillian Fratkin, who has been called to the Torah upon reaching the age of mitzvot, with reverence for God, the Torah, and Shabbat. May the Holy One protect and sustain her, helping her to be wholehearted in her faith, to study Torah and fulfill mitzvot, and to walk in God's ways. May she have the strength to find her calling, to be a person who is both loving and beloved, and may she find love and compassion today and every day in your eyes and in the eyes of all who see her. May her parents continue to rear her to maturity, guiding her to a love of Torah, to the blessing of loving and respectful of relationships, and to a life of good deeds. And let us say, Amen.
Amen. Jillian, Mazal Tov. I know you have a little bit more to chant. We're very excited to hear you chant a little bit more. But before we do that, we wanted to offer a special present and gift to you. This has been such a journey, I know, for both you and Justin, but so you have hopped on and learned so much with me. It's been such a pleasure to learn with you. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. And we have some things for you to never forget this wonderful day, this beautiful day that we were able to celebrate with you. We have a certificate in here so you can always remember that today and your Torah portion, Tazria Mitzora, and then also a book from the rabbi and I, which you will be able to read and continue your Jewish learning. So, and another present in there for you, a gift from our community, which you will hear a little bit more a little bit later. But Jillian, we are so proud of you and so glad to be with you and your family and some of your friends here. What a blessing that we're able to be here together. So Mazal Tov, and we'll sing together. Simin Tavu, Mazal Tavu, Mazal Tavu, Simin Tavu, Simin Tavu, Mazal Tavu, Mazal Tavu, Simin Tavu, Simin Tavu, Mazal Tavu, Mazal Tavu, Simin Tavu, Yevanu. Chazak, chazak.
Torah, 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 Tor
Yeshiva Manu Moshe. Torah, 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 Tziva Manu Moshe.
Morasha Keilat Yaakov.
Morasha Keilat Yaakov.
Morasha Keilat Yaakov.
Torah, Tziva Manu Moshe.
Maybe seated. Welcome, Justin, to the Reader's Table. Chant for us this the Haftorah. It's not this morning's Haftorah. It's actually the Haftorah from the Parsha last Shabbat. Last Shabbat was last year, Justin's original bar mitzvah date. We got a hot mic somewhere, okay. Justin's original bar mitzvah date. And so he is gifting us, blessing us with chanting that Haftorah this Shabbat, which is exactly a year from his original date, but nevertheless, because of the way the Jewish calendar works out, it's a different Parsha this week. So he'll be reading the Haftorah from Parshat Shmini, which is found in 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 1. Still an appropriate one for this Shabbat, as it discusses the dedication ceremony of Solomon's temple. And now we gather together in a process of rededicating our sanctuary as well. Page 645 in Eitz Chaim, page 454 in the Hertz.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam asher bachar bivim tovim v'ratzah v'divrehem ha'ne'marim be'emet. Baruch atah Adonai Habocher v'Torah uv'Moshe avdo uv'Yisrael amo uv'invie ha'emet v'tzedek.
Amen.
V'yasir ela v'yasif od David kol bachar b'Yisrael shalashim alef v'yakom v'yelech David v'chol ha'am asher ito mi'ba'ale Yehuda l'ha'alot misham et arun ha'elohim asher nikra shem shem Adonai tzva'ot yoshef ha'kiruvim alav v'yor ki hivu et arun ha'elohim el agalah chadasha v'yisa'uhu Bibet Avinadav Asher Bagiva Veyuzav Veachyo Bene Avinadav Nohagim et Hagalah Chadasha Vaisa Uhu Mibet Avinadav Asher Bagiva Im Arum Ha Elohim Veachyo Chole Rifne Ha Arun Vidavi V'chol Beit Yisrael Mesachakim Lifnei Adonai B'chol Atzei Bereshim Uchinorot Uvin Valim Uvtupim Uvin Na'ani'im Uvtzaltelim V'yavu Ad Gor Nachon V'yishlach Uzah Et Aron Ha'elohim V'yochez Bo Ki Shemitu Habakar V'yicharav Adonai be'uzah, v'yakehu sham ha'elohim al ha'shal, v'yamud sham im arum ha'elohim. V'yichar l'David al asher paratz Adonai peretz be'uzah, v'yikra l'makom ha'hu peretz uzah, Ad Hayom Hazeh Vayivrah David Et Adonai Vayom Hahu Vayomer Eich Yavo Eli Aron Adonai Velelava David Lechasir Elav Et Aron Adonai Al Yir David Vayatehu David Beit Ovid Edom Hagiti Vayashev Aron Adonai Beit Oved Edom Hagiti Shlosha Chodeshim Vayivarech Adonai et Oved Edom ve'et Kol Beito. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam Tzor Kol Ha'olamim Tzadik Bechol Hadorot Ha'el Ha'ne'eman Ha'asher. Hamidabir Umkayim Shekhol Devarav Emet Vatzedek Ne'eman Atahu Adonai Eloheinu Ve'ne'emanim Devarecha Ve'devcharecha Midbarecha Achor lo yashu Rekam Ki Amelch Ne'eman Ve'rachaman Atah Baruch Atah Adonai
Baruch Shemo
Ha'el Ha'ne'eman Bechol Devarecha
Amen
Rachim Al Tzion Ki Beit Chayinu, V'la'uluvat Nefesh Toshia, B'mhera V'yameinu, Baruch Atah Adonai,
Baruch Shmo,
Misameach Tzion Bevanecha,
Amen.
Sameheinu Adonai Elohinu, Be'eliyahu Hanavi Avdecha, Uv'malachit Beit David Mashiachecha, B'mhera Yavo, Al Gil Libeinu, Al Kiso Lo Yishev Zar, Below you, Halu et Acherim Ekevodo, Kivashim Kojacha, Nishbata lo, Shelo Yifbe, Nero Leolam, Vaed, Baruch Atah Adonai, Magain David,
Amen.
Al HaTorah, the Al Havodah, the Al Hanavim, the Lokum Hashabat Hazeh, Shenatata Lanu, Adonai Eloheinu, Lidusho, Lib. Belimenucha, Becha, Vehud Ulti Varet, Al Hakol, Adonai Elohinu, Anachnu Vodichlav, Umarchim Otach, Yitbarach Shimha, Befi Kochai, Tami Leolam, Vaed, Baruch Atah Adonai,
Baruch Shema,
Mekadesh HaShabbat,
Amen. Yishkoach, Justin, beautiful job on that Haftorah. And Yishkoach as well to Jillian on your Torah reading. Beautifully done. We'll now invite both of you to the reader's table as a representative of our men's club, David Lowenstein, offers you a special presentation. David, are you there? You're still on mute, it looks like. David, it looks like you're still on mute. There you go. Are you there? Justin, why don't you have a seat for a moment, and I'm going to, Jillian, why don't you have a seat for a moment, invite Justin to share with us some words of Torah.
Well,
Welcome, everyone. It is really great to finally be here on the Bema. I am happy to see you all here, and I really appreciate our friends and family that are virtual with us today. As it is said, third time's a charm. Since we've been planning this day, I've grown 5 or more inches. However, I promise the length of my speech remains the same. The name of my Torah portion is Shemini. It is found in the book of Leviticus from chapter 9, verse 1 to chapter 11, verse 47. It begins with Moses explaining to Aaron and his sons what offerings are granted to bring to the temple. Aaron places the offerings onto the altar, carefully following what Moses has said to him. After the ceremony, two of Aaron's sons, Nadab and Abihu, decided to bring their own offerings to the temple. They are punished with death for bringing offerings that were not commanded by God. Moses tells his brother Aaron and his other two sons, Eleazar and Etamu, not to mourn for them. However, instead of focusing on death, I'm going to focus on another topic addressed in my parsha, the laws of Kashrut. Kashrut explains what foods are permitted to eat and what foods are forbidden. I have always wondered why we were given these laws, because it seems random. Why can we eat cows but not pigs? And why is eating meat and dairy prohibited? I've looked for a real explanation regarding the questions of Kashrut, such as cleanliness, meat and dairy, etc. Over the centuries, rabbis have explained this in many different ways. Rabbi Moses Maimonides, a Jewish philosopher, thinks that certain foods are unfit for human consumption. Kashrut helps avoid foodborne illnesses while also remaining spiritually healthy. To avoid foods affected by bacteria and other diseases, we follow the laws of Kashrut. This was commanded by God 3,000 years ago and continues in our lives today. Rabbi Isaac Arama, a Spanish scholar who lived in the 15th century, also thought that these laws were in place for medical reasons. And a Hasidic master named Rabbi Levi Isaac said that the laws have to do with discipline. According to Rabbi Levi Isaac, if a person is not careful about what they eat, they are likely to be insensitive and careless about other things too, especially about what they say. I found Rabbi Levi Isaac's interpretation to be meaningful to me. Having discipline is required to be successful in whatever you do. If you have discipline in what you eat, you could be healthier and in better shape. This is why I think the laws of Kashrut can seem odd, but in reality, they are making you live a more disciplined lifestyle. I personally relate this to my tennis game. As a tennis player, I have learned in order to become a better player, I have to be disciplined in many ways. The more I play tennis in practice, the more confident I find myself becoming. So, for my mitzvah project, I decided that I wanted to give others the opportunity to play tennis as I have. I decided to collect tennis rackets so that I could donate them to the Metro Richmond Tennis Club and the Rising Stars Tennis Academy. So far, I am proud to say that I've collected 100 rackets plus 20 grips. I am working towards 80 more grips, so I have enough for each racket to help out both of these organizations. In conclusion, I have learned so much. I want to thank you, Rabbi Knopf and Kenner Rosenblatt, for helping me study for my bar mitzvah and working with me to make this day happen. We did a lot of work over the phone and Zoom, and I know it wasn't an easy task. Thank you very much. I would especially like to thank my family for supporting me through this long process. Most importantly, I thank you, Mom and Dad. You have planned this special time for me and made it the best bar mitzvah possible in a COVID world. It has been, for the most part, a lot of fun and a great experience to share a B'nai mitzvah with my sister Jillian. We'll talk about this day together forever. Once again, I thank all of you for making this such a special time for me and my family. Thank you.
And your shakoach, beautiful job, Justin. And now we'll invite Jillian to share with us some words of Torah.
The relief of today is immense, but it's also been a great learning experience. The name of my Torah portion is Tazria Mitzora. This relates to people with diseases and impurity of the skin in ancient times. It also states how these diseases were treated. The story of how the Jewish people handled these diseases in ancient times is retold in the book of Leviticus 12, verse 1 to chapter 15, verse 33. The reason we read these stories now is to recall the past events and how Jewish people handled them in the past. It's interesting to look back and see how smart Jewish people were without modern science, and how much we know now from the recent pandemic. When I thought of my Torah portion, I thought it'd be a story about Moses saving the Jewish people. but in my case, I got it all wrong. Instead, I got the Torah portion dreaded by all Bar Mitzvah kids, Tazaria Mitzorah. It's possibly the most disgusting parasha in the entire Torah. It starts out with Moses talking about purification of the mother after childbirth and the inequality between a boy and a girl. For example, a mother that gives birth to a girl remains impure for a longer period of time than giving birth to a boy. And later on, with little to no transition, it starts to talk about boils, rashes, fungal infections, and other skin diseases. It also says how one should isolate themselves from the public when they have one of these infections or diseases. It's similar to what we're experiencing now and how we're handling it. This particular disease is called Tzara'at, and it's highly contagious. Infected people had to wear face coverings to keep the disease from spreading. If someone had any signs of the infection, they had to get examined by the priests. If the priests pronounced them unclean, they had to isolate themselves outside the community for a week. After that 1 week was over, they got re-examined. If the priest pronounced them pure, they could return to the community. If they were pronounced unclean, they returned to isolation. This process repeated until they were pronounced pure. This process is very similar to the way we handle COVID today. I would like to ask Moses how he would handle current day COVID. It sounds like we were handling COVID very similar to how the priests handled the skin diseases. If patients have symptoms, they get tested. If they're pronounced positive, they have to quarantine. After quarantining, they get tested again. If they're pronounced negative, they can return to the community. A long time ago, face coverings were worn to keep the diseases from spreading. And today, face coverings, or masks, are also worn to prevent COVID from spreading. Schools were shut down then, and schools have also been shut down now. Since we have modern technology today, things are a bit different, but each time period basically had the same ideas. And the priests would handle COVID in a similar way to how we handle COVID today. Switching subjects to my mitzvah project, I decided to collect school supplies for a public school in need so that when kids go back to school in the fall, they will have new supplies. I'm planning to collect new pens, pencils, and paper, and plan to donate enough supplies to fill kids' backpacks when they go to school in September. I want to thank my mom and dad for making this all possible, even with all the restrictions. Even though it hasn't been the easiest time to plan, to say the least, they made it happen. A big thanks to my cousin Aaron for helping me be prepared and also making it so much fun. A special thank you to Rabbi Knopf and Cantor Rosenblatt for helping me study for months. I really appreciate everyone being here, regardless if you are virtual or here with us today. And lastly, I want to thank Justin for doing our B'nai Mitzvah together. You've actually been fun to work with, at times.
Why don't you stay up there, Dr. Jillian? Justin, why don't you join her? I'm not used to doing this at such a distance, but we'll give it a try. For those of you joining virtually, it might look awkward that I'm not looking at you. I'm trying to look at Justin and Jillian. I also want to make sure that we thank our Director of Youth Learning, Ramona Brand, and our whole wonderful religious school staff for all of their hard work and ingenuity in general, helping Justin and Jillian reach this moment, for their incredible leadership in the course of this difficult time. But Justin, Jillian, let's turn to you. Mazel tov, you did it. I know how long and winding and uncertain and, well, strange the journey has been for both of you, for Justin in particular, to make it to this moment. But you've navigated all the twists and turns, challenges and changes with grit and determination, grace and good humor, patience and perseverance. You've both exhibited the discipline Justin talked about, and the insight and resilience Jillian spoke about. And through those virtues, you've accomplished something significant, meaningful, and lasting. According to legend, as the children of Israel are walking through the split sea of reeds, amazed by God's great miracle, two Israelites were thoroughly unimpressed, fixated instead on the muddy ground beneath their feet. The pair kvetched and complained about having to trudge through the muck as they walked through the parted waters. For them, there was no miracle, only mud. My teacher, Rabbi Ed Feinstein, concludes this story by suggesting that these two Israelites might still be wandering around in the wilderness somewhere, looking down at their dirty feet, lost and grumbling. So many of us let the muck of life distract us from the miracles that are with us every day, as the Daily Prayer Book puts it. We complain more than we praise. We focus more on negatives than positives. The mundane and trivial receive more attention than the awesome. And like those two Israelites, the more we fixate on the mud, the more the mud becomes all we see, and the more lost we become. Only those Israelites who are able to remain mindful of the miracle merited to receive Torah. So I want you to take a moment and appreciate all the miracles of this day. That we are all here, first and foremost, thank God, alive and well, after an extremely trying and traumatic year. That Justin may be 6 inches taller than he was when he was supposed to be celebrating his bar mitzvah, but he still has his sweet smile. That I even think I saw Jillian crack a smile once or twice this morning. That we have vaccines becoming increasingly available to enable us to gather in person once again, as well as courageous frontline healthcare workers continuing to risk their lives to keep us healthy. That your family and friends have gathered from near and far, in person and online, to celebrate with you by the hundreds. That your hard work and humor, determination and discipline enabled you not only to reach this moment, but to do so successfully. That this is the first B'nai Mitzvah we are celebrating in the sanctuary since the pandemic began. And your grandfather's was the first B'nai Mitzvah, double B'nai Mitzvah ever celebrated at Temple Beth El. The list of miracles goes on and on. Only those of us who can manage to pay attention to the miracles in our lives, however small or subtle they may be, and not get distracted by the negative and the mundane, or lost in the self-perpetuating cycle of cynicism and banality, will experience divine revelation. So for right now, just take a beat. Look past whatever pain you experience preparing for this day, whatever difficulties you encountered along the way, whatever curveballs life threw at you, and I know life threw many, whatever didn't go perfectly according to plan this morning, and instead look out. Go ahead. Look around you. Look up. And appreciate and celebrate the miracle of this day. Jillian, as you taught so eloquently in your Dvar Torah, this Shabbat we read the double Torah portion known as Tazria Mitzorah, an otherwise obscure and notoriously opaque text, replete with discussions of impurity, bodily emissions, skin lesions, and moldy outbreaks in fabric and masonry. As Jillian mentioned, Tazria Mitzorah is the bane of B'nai Mitzvah. Justin, you were supposed to celebrate your bar mitzvah a year ago on Shabbat Parshat Shmini, but which is a much more accessible and forgiving parsha, but Tazria Mitzorah has its diabolical ways of capturing as many unsuspecting B'nai Mitzvah as it can into its tangled web, and here you are. But hidden within this arcane text is a passage that has long intrigued me and strikes me as particularly meaningful as we gather today to celebrate your becoming B'nai Mitzvah. In chapter 14, verse 34 of Leviticus, God instructs Moses and Aaron, when you enter the land of Canaan that I give you as possession, and I inflict an eruptive plague upon a house in the land you possess. Many of the traditional commentators note something strange about that verse. The Israelites receive the commandment while they're still in the wilderness, before they enter the promised land. But the verse implies that they already have houses in Canaan. How can that be? A Midrash explains that the houses to which the verse refers belong to the Canaanites, the indigenous inhabitants of the Promised Land. When the Israelites conquer the territory, they will dispossess the Canaanites and acquire and inhabit their homes. This helps resolve a second peculiarity of the verse. God says, when I inflict an eruptive plague upon a house in the land, and not if I inflict an eruptive plague. Why does God promise this inevitable eruption of mold in the masonry? According to legend, when the Canaanites heard that the Israelites were coming to conquer the land, they hid treasure in the walls of their homes. Once the Israelites move in, God will afflict the homes, which will force the Israelites to tear them down, which will enable them to discover the buried treasure. The unfortunate circumstance will in fact turn out to be a blessing. Only when they destroy their houses will they be able to discover the hidden gold. So it is with us. I would never wish this past year on anyone, anywhere, at any time. But the challenges of this past year have revealed some surprising treasures, enabling you to grow beyond what you were in the before times. In so many ways, this is what it means to become a Bar Bat Mitzvah. Why we put tweens through a rigorous process of learning and preparation, why we have students stand up in front of their family, friends, and community in their most awkward phase. Not you guys. Because maturity requires the recognition that sometimes our most difficult experiences are also the very things that provide us an opportunity to discover extraordinary treasures. Our metaphorical houses may get torn down, but when they do, riches are revealed in the rubble. Becoming an adult means not running from or avoiding those challenges, but confronting and even embracing them as opportunities for enrichment, growth, and even transformation. That's why in our tradition we associate adulthood with responsibility. Living a life of Torah is not easy. If practicing the mitzvot were natural or intuitive, we wouldn't have to be commanded to do them. Being an adult means that we do some things not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because only in surmounting those obstacles can we become more, better versions of ourselves. And this one is really important, so I want to make sure you hear me. Because confronting our own challenges enables us to realize that there are those who struggle in life even more than we do, arousing our compassion and inspiring us to work relentlessly to help lift them up. The Jewish responsibilities you take upon yourselves today are for your benefit. And even more importantly, they call upon you both to use your gifts and your relative advantages to benefit others and our society and the world as a whole. Today, you take your first steps on that journey. You're blessed to have parents, grandparents who model those commitments. I pray that they continue to teach you and that you continue to learn from them. You have a loving community who share in those commitments. You are now adult members of that community. And I pray that you will stay involved in our congregation so that you can support others on their Jewish journeys and so that they can continue supporting you. And you have each other. You may not realize it now, but that is perhaps the greatest treasure of all. I pray that you model what it is for brothers and sisters to care for and lift one another up, so that the whole human family, all of us, brothers and sisters, can be inspired to follow your example. Mazel tov. Amen. I want to invite David and Esther, if you would join Jillian and Justin. Normally we would get close with our B'nai Mitzvah for Birkat Kohanim, but Cantor and I will...
Yeah, maybe they can stand in the center?
That would be wonderful, yes,
yeah.
Please. And Justin, Jillian, why don't you stand in front of your parents? And you guys can place your hands on them if you want, as we offer the priestly blessing. May the Holy One bless you and protect you. May the Infinite smile upon you and dwell close by you. May the Eternal look upon you with favor and grant you peace. Amen.
Amen.
Mazel tov. You can give Mom and Dad a hug and a kiss if you haven't already. And we will conclude our time. Torusar is beginning on page 181 with Ashray.
Together, page 185.
Yaakov. El Hey Sarah, El Hey Rivka, El Hey Rachel, El Hey Leah. Ha El Hagadol Hagibor Hanera, El Elyon, Gomel Chasadim Tovim, Vekone Hakol, Vizacher Haseavet, Umi Vigole Livne Vnechem, Uma Anshmo Bahava, Mela Uzer Umukade, Umashia Umugain, Baruch Hatadina,
Umashmo,
Magain Avraham, Invocate Sarah,
Amen.
Ataki Borle Lamadinai, Mechaye Metimata Rufushia, Mori Hatal. Mechakel chayim bechesed, chayim metim berachamim rabim.
Somech noflim
derachet
holim,
umatir asurim,
umechayim memunato, lishenei afar, michamocha bagurot, umidomela, melech menit umechayet, Umasiyah Yeshua,
Ne'eman Atalach Ha'alot Beitim, Baruch Atah Adonai, Mechaye Ha'meitim,
Amen.
Ha'aritzecha v'nachtishecha, Yesotziyach, Zarfe Kodesh, Ha'matishim Shimcha V'kodesh, Kakatu Laya Nevi'acha, Kadosh, 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 Adonai Tzivot, Melech Kol Haaretz Kivodo, Kivodo Male Olam Mishartam Sholim Zelaze, Ayeh Mekom Kivodo, Umatam Baruch Yomeru,
Baruch Kivod Adonai Mimkomo,
Baruch Kivod Adonai Mimkomo, Mimkomo Vuyipen Rachamim, Yechon Amam Yachadim Shemo, ערב הבוקר בכל יום תמיד, פעמיים באהבה שמה אומרים.
שמה ישראל, אדוני אלוהינו, אדוני אחד.
הוא אלוהינו, הוא, שמה ישראל, אדוני אלוהינו, אדוני אחד. הוא אלוהינו, הוא אבינו, הוא אבינו מושינו, והוא ישמינו ברכה מבשני לעיני כל חי, ויוד לכם אלוהים.
אני אדוני אלוהינו.
Ani Adonai Lechem, Uthivrei Kodshech HaKatuv Lemor.
Yimlochan Elam Elohayich Tzion, Nedor Vador, Aliyah.
Yimlochan Elam Elohayich Tzion, Nedor Vador, Aliyah. Nedor Vador Nagi Kodlecha, Ulo Netzach Netzachim Kirushatecha Nakdish, Veshifach Haloheinu Kinilo Yamush Leilom Baed, Ki HaMelech Gadol VeKadosh Ata, Baruch Ata Adonai, HaEl HaKadosh.
Amen.
Amen.
Source of blessing as those in mourning and those observing Yahrzeit and all who wish to say Kaddish rise as you're able and unmute yourselves as you're willing for the words of the mourners Kaddish, page 207. Yitgadal v'yitgadash Shemei Rabbah.
Amen.
Ve'alma divra kirutei ve'amlich mahutei v'chayichon v'yomechon v'chayei l'chol beit Yisrael v'agala v'izman kari v'imru. Amen. Yehe Shemei Rabbah v'vorach ve'alam olme omaya v'yibarach Tabach v'pa'ar v'chomam v'nase v'tudar v'talev v'talal shemeid v'kudusha b'richu v'ela min kol berchata v'shirata tushbechata v'nechamata d'amiran v'alma v'imru amen yehei shlama rabba min shemaya v'chaim alenu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen oseh shalom yiromav v'yaseh shalom alenu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. May the one who makes peace on high make peace for us, for all Israel, for all who dwell on earth. And let us say,
Amen.
And may be seated. Shabbat Shalom once again. Mazel Tov to Justin and Jillian, to the entire Fratkin family. Such a joy and such a privilege to be able to celebrate with you this Shabbat. We wish Yasher Koach to everybody who participated in our services today and everybody who contributed to make them so special. We want to thank especially David and Esther Fracken for sponsoring our upgraded tech package. It is quite the undertaking to do services this way, but we're so grateful that you were able to enable us to do it in style beauty. Thank you to our Zoom gabbies, Lexi Pasternak and Abby Miller, and to the whole Elevate AV team for everything that you did today and beyond, and to our floor gabbies, David Ruby and Ed Mullen. It's nice to see you back in action and back in the swing of things. There is a lot happening at Temple Beth El over the next couple of weeks, so please take a look at your Shabbat announcements or at our website to be up to date on everything. We hope that we'll have a chance to be with you virtually
or in person in the coming weeks. And we'll turn now to Adon Olam, page 211.
Adon Olam, Asher Malach,
B'Terem Kol Yetzir Nivra, V'Ein Masa, B'Pesachol, Azay Melech Shema Nikra Adon Olam, V'Acharei Kiklot HaKol, Levado Yimloch Nara Adon Olam, V'Hu Haya, V'Hu Hoveh, V'Hu Yiyeh V'Tifara Adon Olam,
Asher
Malach,
B'Terem Kol,
B'Terem Kol, Yetzir Nivra, V'Ein Masa, B'Chesakol, Azay Melech Shemo Nikra Adon Olam,
V'Hu Echad,
V'Ein Sheni, L'Hamshilo L'Hafira Adon Olam, V'Li Reshit, V'Li Tachlit, V'Lo Ha'oz V'Am Yisra Adon Olam,
Adon Olam,
Asher Malach,
Asher Malach,
B'Terem Kol,
B'Terem Kol,
Yetzir Nivra,
V'Ein
Masa,
V'Ein Masa,
V'Chesakol, Azay Melech Shemo Nikra Adon Olam,
V'Hu Eli,
V'Chai Goli, V'Tzor Chavli, V'Ein Tzara Adon Olam, Ve'unisi umanosli, ve'lat kosi v'yom nekra Adon Olam,
Adon Olam,
Adon Olam,
Asher Malach,
Asher Malach,
B'Terem Kol,
B'Terem Kol, Yetzir Nivra,
V'Ein Masa,
V'Ein Masa,
V'Chesakol,
Azay Melech Shemo Nikra Adon Olam,
Ve'ayado
Akiruchi, Be'et Ishan Ve'ayira Adon Olam, Ve'imruchi Geviyati, Adon Ani Ve'lo Yira Adon Olam,
Adon Olam,
Adon Olam,
Asher Malach,
Asher Malach,
B'Terem Kol,
B'Terem Kol,
Yetzir Nivra,
V'Ein Masa,
V'Hesakol,
Adon Olam.
I invite you to put your arm or your arms on the person or people who are with you. If you happen to be in a family pod, it's safe to do so. If you're with people virtually. If you're not, I invite you to just hold our entire community in your hearts as we pray. Yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha. Ya'er Adonai panav elecha v'yichunecha. Yisa Adonai panav elecha v'yasem lecha shalom. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat 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 Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat 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 Shalom. Shabbat 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 Shalom. Shabbat 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 Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat 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 Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. Good Shabbos. You guys did great. Okay, take your mind packs off and just leave them right up here. Don't forget your dad, okay? And your gifts, and then you can go talk to your family. You guys did great. Mazel.
May you have auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous, sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. Or may the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. Or may the road less paved be the road that you follow. Oh, well, here's to the high.
possible ways to love you. I want you to have it.
May you have auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous, sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. May the road less paved be the road that you follow. Oh, well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, you got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. I want you to have it all. A slap bracelet. May you keep the chaos and the clutter off your desk. May you have unquestionable health and less stress. Having no possessions, though immeasurable wealth. May you get a gold star on your next test. May your educated guesses always be correct. And may you win prizes shining like diamonds. May you really own it each moment to the next. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. May the road less paved be the road that you follow. Oh. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, you got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. I want you to have it all. If you believe it, then anything can happen. Go, 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 raise your glasses. Go, 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 you can have it all. I told you, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you.
Stringing us along, just just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place yours.